to take a second to go ahead and talk about something that just happened to me, because literally I cannot. Let me put my shades on to try to hide the disdain. I went out on a casual little like get to meet and greet with this dude who we have both canceled on each other multiple times. We go to like a local little bar thing, and you know, he orders two drinks, I order one. He's like, let's go eat. I'm like, sounds great, like cool, we'll go eat. I asked for the checks and he's like, yeah, the checks. And I'm like, okay. He proceeds to pay with his bill in cash and I pay mine, you know, with my card. We walk out and this man, I'm like, yeah, no, I'm not gonna go. And he's like, are you sure? And I'm like, yeah, no, not for me. The fuck I look like, you got me fucked up. This man then proceeds to call me on my way home as I'm complaining to my homegirl about what a fucking horrible idea this was. And he's like, what was it? And I was like, bro, you know, it's the checks things. And he's like, well, I don't owe you anything. And like, this is not how I wanted to meet. Excuse me?
So as far as I'm concerned, you already know me. I mean, I don't have a problem paying for somebody, especially if we're going to go on a date, if we're going to meet up or something like that. But you have to understand, in this situation, homeboy dodged a bullet, because look at her attitude. Look at the energy that she's bringing, man. As far as I'm concerned, that energy, that attitude, that's exactly why she more than likely is going to stay single later into her years in her life. Don't get me wrong. She'll have all these partners and this and that, but she ain't going to be in no committed relationship that she wants. What's going on? It's your boy Webb back again with another video. And today we're going to take a look at a couple videos or just, you know, have to do with this selfishness, I would have to say, and these unreal expectations. But before we even get into it, make sure if you're new, subscribe to the damn channel, man. We're on the road to 1,000 subscribers. The goal is to get to 1,000 subscribers before Thanksgiving, so make sure you share the video and also subscribe to the damn channel, man. Other than that, let's just get right into the damn video. Interesting part about this is just the fact that this is deal breaker. Like, that's crazy. It's crazy to think that, like, these women out here and some of these girls, because yes, some of you are just young girls thinking that you're sophisticated. Oh, I'm a woman. Nah, some of you just young little girls out here, you're really getting upset, you're really getting triggered over the fact that somebody doesn't want to buy you something. I don't understand the situation here. That's so interesting to think about, though, because as far as I'm concerned, now I'm different from everybody else when it comes to these type of situations, because I don't expect too much. I don't expect anybody to do anything for me, not because I have like this nihilist point of view or like this point of view like just I'm better than everybody else. It's just the fact that like at the end of the day, like, everybody has their own agendas, everybody has their own, you know, the way they take things, their own perceptions and everything. Everybody got their own life going on here, so I'm not expecting anybody to take care of me. Now don't get me wrong, if we're going to be in a committed relationship, then that is a given, that's an obligation, that's an expectation from the jump. But if we're going to just get to know each other, if we're going to just go out, talk, see if we can get along to the, you know, from the beginning, there's no expectations of this person has to do this, this person has to do that. Now don't get me wrong, it's nice. I'm pretty sure we have all been in situations where we'll go out on a date, go out on some type of, you know, getting to know each other type shit, and yeah, the other person paying for you is nice. Or, you know, you go to the bar with your boys and then you meet people there, people buy new drinks, this and that, everybody's turning up, having a good time. Like, the you know, being courteous is something that feels good, especially when someone's taking care of you. But at the end of the day, don't ever expect that. And if you're expecting that, and then not only that, but you're, you know, getting to the point where you're upset that people are not doing it for you, then I feel like the problem is with you, not so much with everybody else. And this is the reality of things. Like, so be it, you can do what you want to do, but you just have to understand, it's just like everybody, as far as I'm concerned, I mean, the whole chivalry thing, that's one thing. You can have that conversation with whoever's willing to have it. But I feel like, especially in this day and age, because that's the reality of things, you can't always, you know, time is moving forward. The way that social things work now, women are in the workforce more than ever. More women are going to college than men, more so than ever in the whole entire, you know, the process. Traditionally, historically, this is happening more and more than ever. And you have to understand that the paradigm has shifted. Not so much no more are women staying home, taking care of the kids, cleaning the house, this and that, you know, the whole traditional values and all that. It's not like that no more. I'm not saying it should be one way or the other, but you have to understand that things are changing. Not only that, but it's just like people are becoming more independent as far as I'm concerned. You can chalk that up to, you know, changing times, or you could chalk that up to just, you know, what's happened over the last year or two. Like, just a lot of people are becoming more and more independent. As we see, there's plenty of studies out there showing that, you know, young people are staying single later into their lives, and a lot, you know, abstaining from certain things too. You know, it is what it is. The audacity, though, the thing that gets me is just the expectation. Oh, I expect you to do this. Now, those are some traditional values from back in the day. But modern times, especially nowadays, like, those expectations are insane. Don't get me wrong. You know, if I ask a girl out and I want to take her out, I want to treat her, so be it. But I just don't feel like it should be expectation put upon me. Don't get me wrong. I'll still do it. There's no problem with that. But I just don't feel like there should be that type of expectation, just because reverse things. I'm not putting no expectation on her, expecting something out of her because she just happened to want to go on this date with me. But as far as I'm concerned, it creates this culture of just, you know, these little foodie calls, foodie dates, because all these girls out here, they know, oh, if he's a real man, he's going to pay for me, he's going to take me out, this and that, he's going to treat me nice. And it's just like, it's a culture. You know, I'm generalizing, but it's a culture of, you know, these women out here, these young girls anyway, they'll go out and just straight up finesse dudes. They'll just get a free dinner, free steak, a free, you know, trip to the movies or to the amusement park or whatever, not have to pay anything. And their excuse for it is just like, oh, well, if you're a real man, you would pay for me, or if you're chivalrous, or if you were, whatever the case may be. But I just think it's very interesting, to say the least. You know, that all the gasps, they're just so perplexed over the situation, man. It's not that hard to, I mean, I don't know. Like I said before, I'm just a very independent type of person. So I would always just want to, you know, I don't want to show up to the function, show up to the party empty handed. You know what I mean? Like, I don't ever want to do that. And especially if I'm going to go out with somebody and we're going to go, like, you know, have a drink or have some food or anything like that, I don't want to show up empty handed expecting them to pay for me. Trust me, in my book, it makes it that much more better when we do go out on some, you know, neutral or mutual situation. And then, you know, I'm already buying my own stuff or whatever, and then they buy me something in the process. That makes it that much better, because it just makes me realize, like, okay, you know, even though I got my money, I'm fully able, capable, and willing, and I was going to pay, or I was going to do this or do that, and then they do, you know, you a favor, and then they buy something for you, I feel like it means so much more even after that. But I don't know, man. I've never really had those experiences before. As I mentioned before, I have girls buy me food on the first date, man. Like, I've never had that situation before. I mean, I'll pay, but it's just when it's the audacity of, like, oh, like, we'll just go in line, or we'll get a seat or whatever, and then they'll just, oh, when the check comes or when it's time to pay, they just automatically disappear. They step behind you, step to the side of you. Oh, that's when we have problems. Don't get me wrong, I've had those experiences before, but I mean, for every experience I've had like that, I've had somebody pay for me. So, you know, especially these girls, they'll be paying for me. So it is what it is. It doesn't happen to everybody, but I definitely believe that mentality and that, you know, that type of, like, that style of, like, those interactions are just dying off, only just because a lot of people are becoming more and more independent, and those traditional values are just, like, slowly but surely are gonna die. It's just the audacity for me, man. At the end of the day, it is what it is, because it's either, the way that I see it, it's either you're gonna, you know, go along to get along, or you just, you're not going to be along then. That's the way that I see these type of situations. That's why when everybody or anybody comes to me with, you know, relationship advice, or they need some type of, you know, they need to hear something. They need to, you know, get a second opinion on the outside of the relationship. That's the one thing that I've always noticed, is they're willing to compromise too much. They're willing to do too much and not get much back in return. You have to understand these things. This is not the last person you're ever going to talk to. This is not the last person you're ever going to be in a relationship. This is not the last person on the planet where, oh, I got to, you know, make everything the greatest I can make it in this little, you know, relationship between the two of us. You have to understand that. You have to have that abundance mindset. And don't get me wrong, that also goes for, you know, you chicks, you women out there too. You have to have that abundance mindset. But do not step out of bounds with those unrealistic expectations. And I'm going to post another video about that probably sometime this week. You cannot have these unrealistic expectations. And as far as I'm concerned, traditionally, And historically, men don't necessarily have that because, you know, traditionally and historically, women go to men for the providing and for the resources and everything like that. So that's why I would say men are, they live in the real world, at least when it comes to understanding that you have to put out, you have to have that transactional, you know, relationship either way when it comes to you and your, you know, your girl or whatever the case may be. But I thought this was very interesting because, like, there's no, like, in between, there's no neutral ground when it comes to this. People, it's either, oh, you pay or you don't pay, and you're this if you don't pay, you're that if you do. I don't know. As far as I'm concerned, I've never really had to deal with these type of situations. I just feel like it needs to be neutral, but it is what it is at the end of the day. Let me know what you guys thought about the video down below. Make sure if you're new, subscribe to the damn channel, man. We're on the road to 1,000 subscribers. The goal is to get to 1,000 subscribers before the end of November. So make sure you share the video and also subscribe to the damn channel, man. Also, if you want me to react, comment, or give some type of advice, hit me up at thedonwebbspeaks@gmail.com. That's where you can find me. Other than that, it's been your boy Web, man. And like I said, when you get in a relationship, understand why you're going to get in a relationship, because there's just too many damn crazy people out here that will take advantage of you, manipulate you, and everything in between. So make sure you're doing yourself a service, doing yourself justice, and understand why you want a relationship, why you're willing to settle or compromise or whatever for that one person. Because, I mean, it could be detrimental to your health if you choose badly. It's Brandon Boy Webb, man. Peace.